A family heartbroken, grieving the loss of their son, Tate, one of four students killed in the Oxford school shooting last November. They're now working through their loss by trying to help other young people. Tate Myre's father opening up to our Sandra Ali about his son, Tate, who he says was a great person who always put others first.
And they have found a way to honor him with 42 strong. Sandra Ali joins us with more. And Sandra, you talked with Tate's father about the foundation, but also his thoughts about Ethan Crumbly and his parents.
Yeah, that's right, Devin and Kimberly. You know, as you can imagine, he's going through a wide range of emotions right now. He wants someone held accountable for the four students killed that tragic day. But he also says he owes it to Tate to try to make sure this doesn't happen again.
Parts of the Oxford High School building were remodeled before students went back a few weeks ago. But when the doors opened and life moved on for some, there are four students who'll never be coming back.
And everything came to a screeching halt in one day. You know, there's a buildup, you know, with our oldest boy, Trent, you know, graduation's coming, you know, the last football game and then last wrestling match. And then, you know, there's a buildup, it's coming, right? And the same with Ty. And Tate, we still had a half a year plus a full year, right? So there were so many more memories to be made. And just like that, it's over. We have no more memories to make.
Buck Myre wants someone held accountable for the death of his son, Tate, and his fellow classmates. Ethan Crumbly is charged in connection with the shooting, and so are his parents, Jennifer and James.
Are you angry at the Crumblies?
I don't like to use their name, but the shooter did not have very good mentors. It's obvious what we've all read and learned, right? Obviously they're part of the puzzle, no doubt. I mean, they didn't take any time with him. They were out doing their thing and he's doing his thing and they've got a weapon that they just bought. And they know that he's not in a good state of mind, and they should have a pulse on that as parents, and they didn't. They don't care, right? Mm-hmm. I'm angry at them, for sure.
If they were here now, would you have something you'd want to say to them?
I don't know. It's a great question. I'll see them someday, and I'll say it, but I don't know what I'll say. Mm-hmm. It'll come from my heart, because that's the kind of person I am. When it comes to November 30th, you know, something went wrong, right? And there needs to be accountability. There has to be accountability because that's how change happens.
That's why he says he started 42 Strong, a nonprofit in honor of Tate to mentor students who need support, like suspected shooter Ethan Crumbly.
This kid was raising his hand all day long.
Crying out for help.
Now he didn't just come out and say, hey, I need help, but look at the stuff that's out there. He was raising his hand, right? And parents did nothing about it, and school did nothing about it.
So the system failed him.
The system failed him. Failed everybody that day, right? So how can we change that? Like, we need to start making this mental health thing a priority. The kid had nothing. He had zero purpose in his life. That's why November 30th happened. He had zero purpose.
Buck Myre says it's too soon to decide if he's going to attend the criminal trial. For now, he's taking it one day at a time.
Okay, so he gets tried as an adult and he gets prosecuted and he's in for life. And the parents, okay, they get a life sentence, whatever. It doesn't matter. Tate's not coming home. Do I want there to be justice? Yes. Do I want them to walk? No. But at the end of the day, Tate's not coming home.
And at this point, Tate's father says it's too far out to make any firm decisions like you heard about a trial. He says at this point, they're just focused on the foundation, 42 Strong, and really just getting from one day to the next without their son. By the way, our entire interview lasted more than an hour, and you can watch the extended conversation with Tate Myre's dad online. It's on our website. Back to you.
It's heartbreaking. And Sandra, it's such a difficult conversation to have. I know it was long, What struck you the most from what he had to say?
You know, a number of things, Kimberly. There's nothing you can say that could ever comfort someone who has lost a child, obviously, but it speaks volumes about his love for his son. For him to be able to find the courage to be brave enough to open up like that in the hopes that he can inspire some kind of change down the road.
Yeah.
So well composed, but you know, he's just been boiling inside over
Absolutely.
All this. Yeah, really great. All right, Sandra.